Hey everybody, I'm Rick Beato on today's Everything Music. It's What Makes This Song Great, episode 80. If you can believe it, we've done 80 of these. One of my goals this year was actually get to number 80, and then I want to get to 100 by around February or so. So it'll be right about the two-year mark since I started doing this series of What Makes This Song Great. Today's artist is Kansas, and the song is Carry On Wayward Son, coming up next. Carry On Wayward Son, or as most people call it, Carry On My Wayward Son, was off Kansas's fourth album entitled Left Overture, which was released in October of 1976. The song was written by Kerry Livgren, the guitarist, and it was produced by Jeff Glicksman. Everyone knows the harmonized a cappella intro. They also know one of the most classic riffs of all time. Let's check out the intro.
Carry on my wayward son, there'll be peace when you are done. Lay your weary head to rest.
Don't kick drum.
No more.
Organ. Here are the guitar solo. When you solo the guitars, it sounds like it's actually just one guitar part delayed and put in the other speaker, because it sounds like one performance. There's no way two guitar performances would be that exact. Most likely what they did is they took a delay, and let's say they panned the guitar to the left speaker and they delayed it 15 milliseconds, 12 milliseconds, and put it in the right speaker to give it a stereo spread without having to replay a separate take of it. It gives it a really interesting sound. Let's check out the keyboard part next. Next, let's check out the bass and drums together. First of all, you can tell that the bass is played through a bass amp. The other thing you can tell is the kick drum's huge. Next, we have the first solo. Let's check that out. I love how he just jumps right in. Right into picking all those. And then he goes into this. Then slides up to that high C, and then this line. And then. I love how he just articulates, picks all those notes. The time is perfect on it. Timing is great. The intonation of the bends and the licks are amazing. And then into the high E, the bend into that is so great. Love it. That's such a recognizable riff there. And then you hear that organ fade there. Let's check that out. So you have two guitars playing this. Then you have a third guitar playing down lower with a keyboard like this. And altogether, those parts sound like this. Then you have the harmonized ah part that finishes it off. I love how it drops right at the very end. Now we're into the verse. Let's check it out.
Once I rose above the noise and confusion, just to get a glimpse beyond this illusion.
Let's check out that piano part by itself. One thing that's great about that is that it's a real piano. Another thing that's great is that it's a really great part. The keyboard playing on this song and in Kansas in general that Steve does is unreal. I mean, it's just absolutely great. Perfectly played. And the melody goes so well with the piano part. Here's the melody and just the melody and piano together.
Once I rose above the noise and confusion, just to get a glimpse beyond this illusion.
And then it's great singing.
I was soaring ever higher.
Perfect intonation.
But I flew too high. Though my eyes could see, I still was a blind man. Though my mind could think, I still was
and then,
a madman. I hear the voices when I'm dreaming.
Let's talk about some of the other instrumentation that's going on during the verse here, okay? So it starts out with just the piano and voice, but then you can hear the acoustic guitar enter here. Let's listen to that. It's super compressed, beautiful sounding, and has this, I think, like a haunting quality to it, and along with that kind of medieval vibe going on with it. And then here's the bass. Really compressed. If I play the keyboard and acoustic together, listen how they work. Electric guitar enters. I love the drum fill that leads into the chorus. It's a very 70s style drum fill, but the toms are nice and open, a little bit more modern. Listen. Here they are soloed. To me, that sounds like it's clear heads that has a top and bottom on them. They sound totally natural. They don't sound dated. Moving on. Chorus. What's great is that the chorus has the really layered vocals, right? That they have in the intro, but it's just picking electric guitar and then the piano part. So here's the guitar and piano in the chorus. Right here.
I
then at the end of the chorus, we obviously have the Don't You Cry No More.
Lay your weary head to rest, don't you cry no more.
Back to the riff section, right? But there's a little flap, bloom, bum, those flams.
Don't you cry no more.
So the riff keeps coming back as the interlude in the song. Nowadays, you would never get to do that. You don't get to have interludes because people are so in a hurry, they never let the songs develop and have these natural parts to them. Then we're on to the second verse, and the acoustic comes in right at the beginning. Beautiful singing, great melody. Back to the chorus. Once again, so it's all clean instruments here without heavy guitars. And then this is one of the most classic bridges of all time. Let's check out that keyboard solo by Steve Walsh. Unbelievable. Listen. Woo! Here it is with the drums. I love how it just bounces right off the guitar. Oh, so good, so good. Let's talk about the drums here in the bridge. That ride cymbal pattern is great. Love it. Tambourine's great too. Once again, guitar solo. All those pinch harmonics are killer. Listen. Smoking. Just so you know, listen to the bass, what the bass plays in the bridge. It doubles the riff perfectly. Listen. Dead on. When the bridge solo comes in, check out what the other guitar is doing. It plays right off it. That's just perfect orchestration of two guitars. Really, really genius stuff. When the singing comes in the bridge halfway through, there's a different guitar riff. Check it out. That's actually a dual lead. I'll solo it here. So one of the guitars playing. The other guitar starts in G. In case anybody's wondering, I'm playing through my 1971 JMP with a Sur reactive load DI. So I'm coming out of the reactive load. There's no speaker cabinet, right into Pro Tools. And it has some impulse responses. I'm using number 1.3 on here. There's a speaker load on it, but I'm actually able to go right into Pro Tools. So got a killer tone. I'm actually using a gain pedal too. It's a BB exotic BB preamp here. This one, you guys, I'm sure most of you know this. Just to add a little extra gain, if I take it out, here it is, with it in, with it out. I think it sounds better with it out. It just tightens it a little bit. I don't really have any gain on it. I'm just tightening up the low end of the guitar on the front part before it goes in the amp, which makes it have a tighter bottom end. Let's listen to the vocals in the bridge. Right here. Just incredible singing. Goes back to the chorus after the bridge, and then.
Don't you cry.
Come on, give me a break. People used to be able to sing without autotune. It's unbelievable. Listen with the instruments in.
Don't you cry.
Next, we have the modulation to F sharp for the next guitar solo. So it's a new riff. Check it out. Okay, so that lick is. And then the solo over it. Rhythm pickup. Eights. Again. That's all for now. Please subscribe here to my Everything Music YouTube channel. If you're a first-time viewer, don't forget to ring the bell. If you're interested in the Beato book, go to my website at www.rickbeato.com. You can buy things, mugs, t-shirts to support the channel. Check out the new Beato ear training course. It's a course I've been developing over the last 2 years. It was just released a few weeks ago. Go check out the introduction video at BeatoEarTraining.com. Follow me on Instagram at RickBeato1. And if you want to support the channel even more, become a member of the Beato Club. Thanks for watching.